We spoke with the CEO of TransCanada. Have a listen. We asked him what's plan B.
They didn't say no to the pipeline last week. Is basically what they said was, at the end of August, we came to the conclusion of the environmental impact assessment. You know, the conclusion was from the Department of State that there's no impact of the pipeline or limited impact of the pipeline on resources. Then from there, they started a public determination or public comment period to determine, you know, if the pipeline was in the national interest. They heard from Nebraskans some concerns with respect to the siting of the pipeline in close to the Sand Hills area of an aquifer in Nebraska. So what they asked for here was additional information and the potential for, you know, rerouting around those sensitive areas in Nebraska. We've reacted quite quickly. We've sat down with the folks in Nebraska. I think we've come up with an arrangement whereby we can reroute and have the involvement of Nebraskans in the determination of where that pipe's going to go in their state. Speaker Flood has done, I think, a very good job of working with the Department of State and coming up with an arrangement whereby they can work together to complete this additional review. And then once they're done that additional review, we go back to the national interest determination, and we would hope for ultimate approval of the pipeline.
Well, just yesterday, Nebraska Senate voted 45-0 to go ahead and look at some alternative routes, which suggests they're actually open to it. So why didn't you just go with the alternative routes in the first place? Would have been easier.
I think, as I said, the conclusion of the environmental assessment with respect to the route was that the route was technically sound. It had no environmental impacts. The issues that were raised in Nebraska, I think the Department of State has been quite clear, they weren't technical in nature. They've narrowed them down to the scope, which is, you know, the area right around the Sand Hills. And now that they've narrowed that scope and the scope isn't going to be a broad review, it's going to be a narrow review around those limited areas. That's something that, you know, as a company we can deal with. If we had have sort of deviated from that route earlier in the program, I guess one of the issues that we always worried about is, do we end up opening up the whole process for to start over again?
Well, let me ask you, what do you think is the probability that ultimately the Keystone Pipeline gets approved?
I think the probability is very high. This pipeline is too important to national security in the United States, energy security in the United States, and economic development of the United States. The facts are that the U.S. imports some 10 million barrels of oil every day. The fact is the best place to get that oil is from domestic sources.
When do you think it gets approved?
I think that it, as quickly as possible from our perspective. Obviously, we're going to participate in this additional environmental review and we'll cooperate. And I believe that we can get through a review like that in a 6 to 9 month kind of time frame, depending on how they lay out the schedule and what are the things that we need to take a look at. It's in that time frame. The Department of State initially said 15 months. So it's somewhere in that range that I believe that we can finish this additional supplemental work. And at that point in time, we're through, hopefully, you know, all of the environmental issues that are associated with this pipeline.
All right, that was the TransCanada CEO, Russ Girling, and that is big news. Remember, a week ago, the government said, the State Department said, we're not going to allow this pipeline to bring oil down from Canada. There was a lot of opposition against it. He now thinks that this thing can actually happen. You're looking at the chart of TransCanada over the past month, down 5%, obviously sold off on that. He's optimistic. He gets this deal done. That is a big deal. Only here on Bloomberg.